Good morning, everyone. Let us all stand and begin our celebration with our opening song, Open My Eyes.
Open my eyes, Lord. Help me to see your face. Open my eyes, Lord. Help me to see. Open my ears, Lord. Help me to hear your voice. Open my ears, Lord. Help me to hear. Open my heart, Lord. Help me to love like you. Open my heart, Lord. Help me to love.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all,
and with
your spirit. My dear sisters and brothers, coming together as God's holy family, and let us now pause for a moment. We acknowledge our sins, and so we prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance of your mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a ways as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who live and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. A reading from the prophet Jeremiah. Let my eyes stream with tears day and night without rest over the destruction which overwhelms the virgin daughter of my people, over her incurable wound. If I walk out into the field, look, those slain by the sword. If I enter the city, look, those consumed by hunger. Even the prophet and the priest forage in a land they know not. Have you cast off Judah completely? Is Zion loathsome to you? Why have you struck us a blow that cannot be healed? We wait for peace, but to no avail, for a time of healing, but terror comes instead. We recognize, O Lord, our wickedness, the guilt of our fathers, that we have sinned against you. For your name's sake, spurn us not, disgrace not the throne of your glory. Remember your covenant with us, and break it not. Among the nation's idols, is there any that gives rain? Or can the mere heavens send showers? Is it not you alone, O Lord, our God, to whom we look? You alone have done all these things. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Response is, for the glory of your name, O Lord, deliver us.
For the glory of your name, O Lord, deliver us.
Remember not against us the iniquities of the past. May your compassion quickly come to us, for we are brought very low.
For the glory of your name, O Lord, deliver us.
For the glory of your name, O Lord, deliver us. Help us, O God, our Savior, because of the glory of your name. Deliver us and pardon our sins for your name's sake.
For the glory of your name, O Lord, deliver us.
Let the prisoners sighing come before you, and with your great power free those doomed to death. Then we, your people, and the sheep of your pasture, will give thanks to you forever, though through all generations we will declare your praise.
For the glory of your name, O Lord, deliver us.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia,
alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The seed is the word of God, the Christ is the sower, and all who come to him will live forever.
Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus dismissed the crowds and went into the house. His disciples approached him and said, "Explain to us the parable of the weeds in the field." He said in reply, "He who sow good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world, and the good seed the children of the kingdom. The weeds are the children of the evil one, and the enemy who sows them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age, and the harvesters are angels. Just as weeds are collected and burnt up with fire, so will it be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send his angels, and they will collect out of his kingdom all who cause others to sin and all evildoers. They will throw them into the fiery furnace, where there will be a wailing and grinding of teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Whoever has ears ought to hear." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. As I reflected on today's readings, specifically on today's gospel, Jesus invites each one of us to become a part of good wheat, something that can produce kindness, love, generosity, compassion, and integrity. And also, we are called to become part of a good weed, that something that can produce justice and peace in our church, society, and in our own family. In our first reading today, Prophet Jeremiah was really upset with his own people because they choose to walk in injustice. And Jeremiah cried out to God and asked God for the forgiveness and compassion toward God's people. So my brothers and sisters, today God calls us to love justice and peace. And therefore, as we live in Christ and His divine, we are invited to stand with justice and peace for our world, for our society, and for our own family. Jesus promises us today that if we choose to become good wheat, and if we choose to do good and to walk in God's ways, in the new glorious kingdom of God, we all will shine like the sun. We all will be at peace, and we will enjoy, will fill our life forever. Amen.
Amen.
Let us all stand. We come together in faith and love to place before God our prayers and petitions for our Holy Father, Pope Francis. May the Lord look graciously upon him. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For our elected officials, may God's compassion and justice guide them in serving those they represent. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those who find themselves unemployed, may the Lord help them find work to support their families. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those of us who gathered here, may the Lord keep us steadfast in faith and hope. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for our departed, our faithful departed, may they soon rest in the loving arms of Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for our Mass intentions today, we pray for the intentions of Raleigh Martinez. For him and his family, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those who are sick and housebound, will find comfort in the word of God, we pray for Mike Romo. And for those who in our parish book of the sick, particularly with COVID-19, we pray for Rigo Guzman, Pablo and Anita Arellano and family, Meliton Gomez and family, the Zavala Trujillo family, and the Esteban Fuentes family, and the repose of the soul of Esteban Fuentes. For them we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for recently deceased, we pray for Xavier Salvador and Jose Cisneros. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And in the silence of our heart, let us now add our own petition. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, in your mercy, hear and answer the prayers we offer through your Son, our Lord, Jesus Christ. Amen. And blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. And blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. Lord, blessed be God forever. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of God's name, for our good and the good of God's holy church. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so in the company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we acclaim. Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. And you are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At that time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took the bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. And therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, O Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Kevin, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
And together we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us now offer to each other the sign of Christ's peace. Peace be with you. Peace be with you, peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us your peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world, and blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. And let us pray for our brothers and sisters who are watching us and following us from their home. And let us pray for them the prayer of spiritual communion. But please repeat after me. My Jesus, my Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament.
I believe
that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things.
I love you above all things.
And I desire to receive you into my soul. And I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment, since I cannot at this moment, you receive you sacramentally.
Receive you sacramentally.
Come at least spiritually into my heart.
Come at least spiritually into my heart.
As I embrace you as if you were already there.
I embrace you as if you were already there.
And unite myself wholly to you. and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Never permit me to be separated from you.
Amen. Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace. Thanks be to God. Let us salute Mary. Hail, Holy Queen.
Mother of mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee we cry, for banished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious Advocate, thine eyes of mercy towards us, and after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
O Clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.